Good morning, students. In our previous discussion, we had studied about how the atomic orbitals are there inside the atomic orbits imaginarily, and how do we fill up the electrons in the orbits and in the orbitals. So we had seen the slight overview of that. Today we will again see the size and shape of the atomic orbitals corresponding to the shells like K shell, L shell, M shell or N shell, that means the orbits, and then how many electrons can be accommodated in each shell, and based on that how to write down the number of electrons in each orbital in the electronic configuration in ASPDF form, as well as by making box diagram, because every orbital further contains certain sub orbitals. So we will start with the recapitulation little bit, so that if you have just started seeing the video, you will not require to go back and see that. All right, so we'll just see how to write electronic configuration and also show box diagram. For electrons inside orbital and suborbital. So you are very much familiar with the first cell K, that means the order of the cell is 1, that means the first shell, you know, first shell. For K shell, the orbitals present in it is only S orbital, and the shape of S orbital is spherical. For L shell, that means second shell, S and P both are there. So S is spherical and P is dumbbell shaped. So if it is dumbbell shaped, it can be oriented in the Y direction and in the X direction and in the Z direction. So this is S orbital, this is Px, sorry, this is Py, this is Px and this is Pz. Pz is such that it is going inside the board and it is coming out of the board. And Xy is already the plane of this board itself. This is the X axis and this is the Y axis. So Xy plane is the board itself. Away from the board towards U is positive Z, and inside the board towards the other room is minus Z. For M, third shell, S, P and D, all three are available, such that for S spherical, for P, PY, PX and PZ is there. Plus one d orbital is there. Now d orbital is double dumbbelled, such that it is like this. In dxy plane, it is in xy plane, then dyz plane, then dzx plane, then two more, dx square minus y square and dz square. So in this way, the 5d orbitals, 5d sub orbitals are written. So this px, py and pz are sub orbitals of p orbital, and dx dy dz are suborbitals of d orbital. I hope you remember the meaning of orbital. Orbital means the space around the nucleus where probability of finding electron is maximum. Similarly, for n shell, that means the fourth cell, S, P, D and F, all four orbitals exist such that 1s, 3p, px, py and pz, px, py and pz, then 5d orbitals, 3dxy, dzx, dyz, dx square minus y square and dz square. And f orbitals, there are 7 suborbitals, 7 f suborbitals. Now this f orbital being away from the nucleus is so much diffused in its shape that it is not named as per the planes. Like, unlike d orbital, we are not able to name the f orbital because their shape is diffused, because they are away from the nucleus. They are not in the influence of the nucleus so as to assume a particular shape. So they are away from the nucleus, so they are diffused in shape, and hence we number them from minus 7 to plus 7 like that. But we are not able to name them plane wise as we do in case of, say, d orbital. Now, the maximum capacity of s orbital is to hold 2 electrons. So each of the s orbital will hold 2 electrons. Maximum capacity of p orbital is 6 only. So all p orbitals will contain 6 orbital. Maximum capacity of d orbital is 10 only. So all d orbital will contain 10 maximum, and maximum capacity of f is 14. So if you will add this, you will see that k can contain 2 electrons, l can contain 8 electrons, m can contain 18 electrons and n can contain 32 electrons. If you add all these, further, in each of these suborbitals, 2 electrons can be there, and hence as many suborbitals are there, twice of that the electrons can be filled up. That means 7 suborbitals of F are there, and inside there 14 electrons can be filled up. So that can be shown with the help of boxes. Now instead of drawing these shapes, we can draw boxes. Like we can draw 1 box for S orbital, 3 box for p orbital, 5 box for d orbital and 7 box for f orbital. Alright, so we'll draw the electronic configurations starting from the element, say, hydrogen and up to calcium we will do, and with that you will be having the gist of the idea how to write the electronic configuration. For hydrogen, so we used to only write 1 earlier, but now in class 11 you will write it as 1s1, and box diagram will be like this. One box you will make, you will write 1s and you will write 1 electron with upward arrow. I will tell you the meaning of upward arrow after a while. Say helium, 2 electrons. Earlier you used to write 2 only, now you will write 1s2. And then you will write, draw 1 box, you will write 1s, and then instead of 1 full arrow, you will write 1 half arrow in the upward side and 1 half arrow on the other side. Now why it is done side like that? The upward arrow shows clockwise direction of revolution of electron, and downward arrow shows anti-clockwise movement of the electrons filled up, as a result of which their polarity is opposite and hence they can remain each other, in pair. Otherwise, electrons are negatively charged species. Why they should form bond? They are negatively charged species and like charges repel each other. Why they should come closer? They come closer because when electrons revolve or any charged particle revolve, they produce a magnetic moment. So, the direction of the magnetic moment should be such that the opposite poles should face each other, as a result of which the electrons can come close to each other. And hence, in a box, if more than one electron has to be filled up, then one will be written in the upward direction, another will be written as downward direction. Okay? So, since a complete rotation is done by two half rotation, so this representation is also called as half spin, that means plus half spin, and this is called as minus half spin. More about it we will study when we will be studying about quantum number. Okay? By the way, it is nothing but spin quantum number. Spin quantum number gives us the idea of the direction of rotation of electron. It is clockwise or anticlockwise. Lithium 3. Earlier you used to write as K, then comma 1. Now you will write as 1s2, 2s1, and 2p will be there, in which 0 electrons will be there. So the box diagram of this will be 1s, 2 electron, 2s, 1 electron, this is 2s, this is px, py and pz, px, py and pz, and nothing will be there inside, it will be empty. But if you write 2s, you have to write 2p, because it is in the same band. Similarly, beryllium 4, it has 2 electrons in the first orbit, second in the second orbit. So this can be written as (1s2, 2s2, and 2p0), px, py and p0, 2px, 2py and 2pz. They contain no electrons. So it was very easy up to this. Now we will go ahead, in which now electrons are bound to enter into p orbital. Electrons are now bound to enter into the p orbital because 1s and 2s is now completely filled up. After beryllium, which element will come? I had told you to remember the name of the elements in the order of the atomic number. If you would have remembered, then you might be knowing that after beryllium, boron comes. So we will do the electronic configuration of boron now. Boron 5. Earlier used to write as 2, 3. Now you will write 1s2, 2s2, 2p, x1, 2p, y nothing, and 2p, z nothing. Or also you can write, I am trying to be very particular, that's why I have written like this. Else you can also write 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. This will also do. Because this one can be there in x also and can be in the z also. Now, box diagram of this will be like this. 1s, 2s, 2px, 2py, 2pz. So, like this. 5 electrons can be filled up. After boron, which element comes? After boron it comes carbon. Atomic number is 6. Earlier we used to write configuration as 2, 4. Now you will write as 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. Box diagram will be 1s, 2s2. Now there is a cashier, 2px, 2py and 2pz. Now there are two ways. First of all you like write one electron over here and then you write one electron here. Or you can write both the electrons in the same orbital itself. Now what to do? How to make decision? Which one will be correct, which one will be wrong? Here, instead of this electron being filled up over here, that means if I write it like this, then my teacher will cut my marks. This is wrong. This is right. What is the reason? The reason is lying with Hund's maximum spin multiplicity rule. According to Hund's maximum spin multiplicity rule. This can also be written as Hund's rule. In general, we also write as Hund's rule. We don't write so much big. Now, there are two ways of defining Hund's rule or stating Hund's rule. According to Hund's rule, the electron tries to fill up in that atomic orbital in which its value of the spin multiplicity is maximum. Or electron tries to arrange themselves in the atomic orbital such that their spin multiplicity is maximum. Now what is spin multiplicity? Spin multiplicity is nothing but capital S is equal to 2 sigma S plus 1. That means whatever spin quantum number is there, multiply it by 2 and add 1. For whichever arrangement this value will be maximum, that arrangement will be followed. Now, see, if I want to find out the spin multiplicity for this one, so I will use a yellow colored one. So for this, plus half, minus half, 0, plus half, minus half, 0, plus half and plus half. Plus half and plus half will become equal to 2 into plus half plus plus half. Plus 1. That means this will become 3. But for this, if I want to find out spin multiplicity for this arrangement, it will be 2 into sigma s plus half minus half plus half minus half plus half minus half will be equal to 0 plus 1 will be equal to 1. So since 3 is greater than 1, therefore this arrangement is more preferable. Now, when you will write electronic configuration of a number of elements at that time, doing this calculation may be tedious for you for comparing every time. So, an easier statement is also made. Easier statement says that when filling up of electron takes place in the subsequent atomic orbital, then electrons are first singly filled up and then pairing occurs. I repeat, when filling up of the electron in the subsequent orbital takes place, then electrons are filled up first of all singly and then pairing occurs. So when filling up of electron takes place, at that time first it is filled up singly, then pairing occurs. First filled up singly, then pairing occurs. And then first filled up singly, and there is no more electron for pairing up here. So the two statements, I can write it like this now. This much you can note down. This will be an example also. Filling up of the electrons in the subsequent means one after another, orbitals
takes place such that the arrangement or the electronic configuration which has maximum 2s plus 1 value. This 2s plus 1 value is also called as spin multiplicity. Is preferred electronic configuration. Now second statement, this was the easier one, and the one in which the spin multiplicity is not used, it would be like this. Filling up of the electron takes place in subsequent orbitals first singly, then pairing occurs. So whichever statement is easier for you, you can follow. This is statement 1. This is statement 2. So if you compare the previous day's class and today's class, you will find that I have taken a condition of filling up of electron in the 4s orbital of calcium 20 atom, in which 4s2 was filled up before the 3d. And then I had shown that the n plus l value, that means the energy level value of n plus l for 3d was less than, was more than that of the 4s, and hence the electrons entered into the 4s orbital. So that was based on Aufbau principle. According to Aufbau principle, the filling up of electron takes place in the atomic orbital in the order of its energy level, in the order of its energy level. But according to Hund's rule, the filling up of electron takes place in the subsequent orbital such that first of all the electrons are filled up singly and then pairing occurs. Now instead of saying such big sentences, I will summarize it in two ways. Aufbau principle ke anusar, pehle un orbital mein electron enter karenge jiski energy level kam ho, ho gaya. Second is, according to Hund's rule, jab electron ko box diagram mein fill up karenge to pehle single single fill kar denge. सिंगल सिंगल फिल हो जाने के बाद फिर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स को उल्टा करके भरेंगे, तब वो पेयरिंग हो जाएगा, एक ही साथ पेयरिंग नहीं करेंगे. ठीक है, तो ये दो रूल्स हैं. इसको इंग्लिश में भी समझा दिया, हिंदी में भी समझा दिया, टेक्स्ट बुक से भी पढ़ना है, और भी एनिमेशंस वगैरह भेज देंगे, उसको भी देखना है, और सारे लिंक मैं डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में दे दूँगा. ठीक है, सो सिर्फ एक सोर्स ऑफ लर्निंग के ऊपर हम डिपेंड करेंगे, तो हो सकता है कि नहीं समझ में आए. कुछ लोग सुन के सीखते हैं, कुछ देख के सीखते हैं, कुछ करके सीखते हैं. तो आप जिस प्रकार के भी स्टूडेंट हो, उस तरह से अपने लर्निंग स्टाइल को अप्लाई करके इस टॉपिक को आप सीखें. तो मैंने आज कार्बन एलिमेंट तक के इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन बनाए हैं. अगर मैं और भी एलिमेंट्स के इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन ड्रॉ करूँगा तो ये वीडियो का साइज़ बड़ा हो जाएगा और आपका नेक्स्ट क्लास स्टार्ट हो जाएगा. तो लेट दिस क्लास बी अप टू दिस मच ओनली. इन माई नेक्स्ट क्लास आई विल बी राइटिंग डाउन द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन ऑफ द एलिमेंट्स फ्रॉम नाइट्रोजन ऑनवर्ड्स. And then whatever the properties of the elements will be there based on the electronic configuration, whatever rules will come up, we will discuss. All right. And once that is done, then we will come to quantum numbers. That also will be very, very easy for you all. Thank you.